In part one of our lesson on graphs of tangent and cotangent, we are going to create the graph of tangent. So first, a quick review that a rational function, which we're showing has a numerator of x in the top and the denominator of x in the bottom, will have vertical asymptotes when the denominator function is equal to 0 and simultaneously the numerator function cannot be 0. So both of these conditions have to be met for there to be a vertical asymptote. Now we want to create the graph of tangent, and we're going to use the graphs of sine and cosine to do that because we know that tangent of x is equal to sine of x over cosine of x. So it will have vertical asymptotes whenever the denominator, which is cosine, is equal to 0, and the numerator, which is sine, does not equal 0. So we're going to look at these graphs and find places where cosine is 0 and then make sure that sine is not 0 in that same place. So if we look at the denominator first, cosine, we come along the cosine graph and we see that cosine is equal to 0 at negative 3 pi over 2, negative pi over 2, positive pi over 2, and positive 3 pi over 2 on this particular section of the graph we've shown. Now, looking up at the graph of sine, we can see at negative 3 pi over 2, sine is equal to 1, so that would satisfy this condition where it can't be 0. And in fact, every place that the cosine is 0, we can see that the sine is not 0. So then that means everywhere that we have a root in cosine, we are going to have a vertical asymptote on our tangent graph. So let's go ahead and get those in on our graph. Cosine has a root at negative 3 pi over 2, so tangent will have a vertical asymptote there. And again at negative pi over 2, positive pi over 2, and 3 pi over 2. Remember, it's not enough that cosine is 0. It had to also be true that sine was not 0 there, and we verified that before we began. Now that we have the vertical asymptotes in place, let's start getting some points on the graph. So we can plug in a few x values and look at their y values. For instance, if we plugged in x is negative pi over 4, we know that the tangent of negative pi over 4 is negative 1. So we can come over on our graph and plot that point. The tangent of 0 is equal to 0. And the tangent of pi over 4 is equal to 1. So here's what the shape looks like. I suggest that you start at this middle value here and you draw a smooth curve approaching the asymptote in that direction and do the same approaching the asymptote in this direction. Now if we carry on, if we put in 3 pi over 4, that's, if you think on the unit circle, that's in quadrant 2, and the value of the tangent would be negative 1. The tangent of pi is equal to 0, and the tangent of 5 pi over 4 is equal to 1. And once again, you approach the same way. Start from that middle point and draw a smooth curve approaching the asymptote in the positive infinity direction. And then do the same thing, starting at the center point and going to the asymptote in the negative direction. So you can see that the graph is already repeating itself. So this turns out to be one full cycle of the graph. So now we can fill this one in without actually having to plug in the points. We know it's going to go negative 1, 0, positive 1. Make the smooth curve. Make the smooth curve. Now, over here, notice we don't have a full cycle. We don't have room for the entire graph. So it's just the first two points of the graph that we have room for over here. We know the tangent of 7 pi over 4 is negative 1. Tangent of 2 pi is 0. So we would get that much of the graph. Over here, tangent of negative 2 pi is 0. Tangent of negative 7 pi over 4 is equal to 1. And we can draw that piece of the graph. Next, we can start to look at some of the attributes of the graph. We can get the period of the graph by subtracting one of the endpoints minus a starting point of an interval. So if we did pi over 2 minus negative pi over 2, that would be pi over 2 plus pi over 2, which means the period is equal to pi. So that's different than sine and cosine, whose periods are 2 pi. So the tangent function has a shorter period. It's pi. Now, the domain, we can see that everywhere there is a vertical asymptote, the tangent function does not exist. So we do have places where x values are not allowed to be plugged in. Now, in an earlier section, we learned how to use a formula to find all the infinitely many roots of sine and cosine functions, and it's going to be a similar process here. For example, we see that there is an asymptote at pi over 2. There's another one at 3 pi over 2. The distance between pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2 is pi. The distance from pi over 2 to negative pi over 2, we have to back up by pi. To go from pi over 2 to negative 3 pi over 2, we would have to back up by 2 pi. So, we say that the domain is the x values cannot equal pi over 2 plus n pi. The range is the resulting y values, and you can see the graph goes forever to negative infinity in the y direction and up to positive infinity. So the range is all real numbers, negative infinity to positive infinity. The formula for the vertical asymptotes is very easy to get because wherever the domain of the function cannot be, that's exactly where the vertical asymptotes are. So we see right away, using that same logic, we have a vertical asymptote at pi over 2, and then the distance to the other vertical asymptotes is just integer multiples of pi. So the formula for the vertical asymptotes is that x is equal to pi over 2 plus n pi. Now, the piece of the graph that we call the normal cycle It always has to go from asymptote to asymptote, and the standard is to take the piece of the graph closest to the origin. So we're going to take the piece of the graph that starts at negative pi over 2 and stops at pi over 2. So the interval would be negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. And notice those are soft brackets because the function does not exist at negative pi over 2 and positive pi over 2. Now, to get the vertical asymptotes of this cycle, let's see what we would need to plug in for n in the formula for the vertical asymptotes. To get this first vertical asymptote, which is at negative pi over 2, we can see that we need to plug in a negative 1 for n, so that pi over 2 minus pi is negative pi over 2. And to get the asymptote that's here at x equals pi over 2, we need n to equal 0 so that this gets wiped out and we're just left with x equals pi over 2. And let's go ahead and label the normal cycle right on the graph. So we know that we're using this piece of the graph whenever we do our translations later on. So there's our introduction to the graph of tangent of x.